select the unit as mm, precision as 0.0. Start drawing one side of the socket because the figure is symmetrical about the center. Using line command, ortho on position, start sketching one side of the socket and spigot so that we can use mirror command to complete the remaining portions. Using trim command, you can remove unwanted extensions. Use trim command, remove the unwanted extensions. Use mirror command, select all objects to be mirrored. If any object is not selected, select individually. First point of mirror, you select the axis. Mirror source, erase the source object, no. Draw the remaining portions. Want to draw the cotter, starting from center, it is 30 mm from that edge. You can zoom in, zoom out using center roller button. 1:24 taper is given, that is come around 2 degrees. So we want to draw a line 2 degrees with vertical. 2 degrees vertical means 88 from horizontal. You can use less than button to go to angle box, enter 88. Slowly you drag so that you can get that particular intersection point. From there you select, draw a line with an angle 88 so that angle width vertical become 2 degrees. Enter. Trim the unwanted lines. Similarly, you want to draw the other side of the cotter. Here also angle will be 2 degrees with respect with the vertical. With horizontal anticlockwise direction. Trim unwanted lines. Now you want to draw the arc, some reference values required. So 3mm line, vertical line is drawn at the center. 3-point arc. Select the 3 points. Reference line is drawn. Then you select the arc, 3-point arc. Delete the unwanted lines. Now offset that line. Right side also, there is offset is required for cotter. Offset distance, you have to select 3mm. Then you select the objects, you can get the objects offset lines. Now modify break commands. Suppose you want to remove the lines between two reference values, you can use break commands. Using break commands, trim commands, you remove unwanted portions of the lines. Now to draw the cross section, draw one line. Now offset that line, distance of 8mm, that is the cross section width. Select the objects, trim the unwanted. To mark a boundary for section, you can use splines commands. And remove the unwanted lines, unwanted portion using trim commands. using trim commands again, we want to represent the shaft. You select number of points so that it's a smooth curve is drawn through that particular points. You select number of points using enter. Now you remove the unwanted portions. Other side also. Section boundaries marked using spline commands. Remove the unwanted portions. Enter commands. Remove the unwanted portions. Go to hatching. Select the hatch, type of hatch. Select the closed boundaries. You can get a hatch. You select the hatch mark, select the properties, select the lines, color, draw the side view, draw the circles, the required diameter. Draw the center line. Offset. So that here you can draw the cotter, side view of the cotter. Draw the projection lines so that you get the length of the water. Projection lines to know the width of the curved portion. You can zoom in, zoom out using center roller button. Now you can remove the unwanted lines using trim commands. You select the hatch portion. Select the closest boundary, you can get the hatch. You have to draw the cotter with the different portions so that you can vary the properties. Suppose a portion of the lines you want to be a hatched line. Then that portion must be a separate property. So in side view you have to draw the line with the different lines so that individually you can change the properties. Select the properties, line type, hatch lines are not loaded, so you have to load the hatch lines. select the line type, load the required lines, hatch lines, dash lines, etc. Load it so that you can call from the properties. You select, change the properties of as dashed lines. Now you select proper scale. Line type scale. One is given. We change it to 0.5. Now it is displayed. Scaling is okay. So similarly, you have to change the scale. That is done by trial and error actually. Select the properties, change color. Angle is changed so that different portion will have different angles of hatching. Similarly, you can change the color also. Select, go to properties, then select the color. Now to mark the dimensions, go to dimensions, select diameter, drag the mouse, place the dimensions convenient for the location. Dimensions, diameter, and select the. Locate the dimensions at convenient positions. Similarly, you can mark the linear dimensions also. taper, take a leader line, mark 1:24. Now you go to layout, select the layout, right click, page setup manager, select modify A4 size, select A4 size, okay. You can see the A4 size boundary on the white sheet. Our drawing is outside the lines, so drag the boundaries and drag inside the dotted lines so that your printout will come within the A4 size sheet. Now this is in layout. You draw the title box selecting a table, select column equal to 3, row equal to 2, then column width you select as 50. Insert the table within the corner position. Type the heading as socket and spigot joint. Edit the other portion, name, roll number, class, etc. Now we are working on layout. Suppose you want to change the drawings dimension, something like that, you have to double click within the drawings. If you click the boundary, automatically further you can modify the layout. The difference is if you zoom in and zoom out the drawings, the layout will remain as it is. It will not zoom in and zoom out. You can merge the columns or rows, so you can represent the first angle drawings here. To draw the item list, go inside the drawing, insert a table, require dimensions, place the tables in the required location. Place the table near to the drawing. Write item list. Description. Quantity. Material. Fill all data. Export. Export the drawing as PDF files. Save in the convenient location. Thank you for watching the video.